we are entering in Zawali Valley from western coastal plain, that is called as Kokan area. A tar road is available and we have to climb now entire Sahyadri mountain range. We are traveling from Ratnagiri district, Kheda Taluka. The name of this ghat is Raghuvir Ghat, where the road conditions are not that good due to very heavy rain in this area. We are climbing up this Sahyadri mountain. This area is really beautiful area. We can now see that we have started our journey from Mumbai, reached till Kheda, and from Kheda early in the morning we started this journey. At some places road conditions are very good but covered by dense forest, and here the population density is very, very less. My friend Professor Dinesh Kolge, an expert driver, is having very good experience of driving on good road as well as off-road also. This is all we are observing Sahyadri mountain ranges. The rock, the black colored rock what we are observing, that is basalt rock, extrinsic volcanic rock. This is basalt rock, and we are now started our journey. This is some, we are saying that very interesting part, but people are not much of the aware of this part. During monsoon season, various rainfall waterfalls are here. Now this is the upper part of this mountain. We are climbing out this much of height. This is all Sahyadri ranges. At some places landslide is there, so we have to be careful. Yet this part is not that steep. As we are going upside, the left hand side, we are getting very sharp edges of Sahyadri mountain. Now the Sahyadri ranges are spread from north to south direction, and that's why many times we are facing sun straight away, because sun is from eastern side and we are right now propagating from west to east direction. We are entering after some time, obviously we are entering in the Zawali Valley or Koyna Valley, where fantastic locations are there throughout our journey. Is there through Koyna backwater. These places are not much of the people are aware. This is information of Raghuvir Ghat in Marathi language, where there is a availability of lodge. You can see the location of this lodge. This is all ghat, the road in the Sahyadri mountain. We have already covered this much of height. A dam is located over there, that is not Koyna Dam. On Jagbudi River, some dam is there. Whereas area is covered by forest. The sharp edges of Sahyadri mountain. Dam. This is the recording in early morning. So Hedge is there. Now this is Sahyadri Mountain, whereas we are zooming a pinnacle. This place is called as Nageshwar. See, this is now getting clear. This place, this pinnacle center is called as Nageshwar, where Lord Shiva temple is there in the cave. You can observe some cut is there. That is actually the entrance of cave. And very, very nice temple is there. On this channel, we have videos of this Nageshwar area. Just beside right side of this Nageshwar, I'm zooming again to the right side. So this is Nageshwar. To the right side, we can locate out a fort. That is very nice fort. That is Vasota Fort. So we are observing this main stream of Sahyadri Mountain. This is developed by MTDC. A nice spot is developed. So I hope for night stay, this is very nice. We can make your night halt here. Solar lamps are available. But lodge is just beside. A very nice location is there. I'm now making photographs from other side. This point is developed. We can walk straight way. Protection is also available because we are walking straight way to the downside here. From the top of hill we are going. So I'm intentionally making this recording so you'll get idea. And now here the Sahyadri ranges, but now what we are observing, that is Mahimandanagad. We are going just through that Mahimandanagad foothills. We are going. So this is sharp valleys and we are on the top. No doubt electricity availability is there. Actually, we started our this trekking somewhere around 1990s. At that time in Maharashtra, various places, particularly this type of remote places, we were not having electricity. That's why we are having this idea that okay, electricity is there or electricity is not there. Now this is very well maintained steps. They are there, my friend Milind Bhosle. We can get down. My another friend Dinesh Kolge is already getting down. This is Mahimandanagad. This is top part of Sahyadri. After that we had to get down to the Javri Valley. This is hardly 1 to 2 minutes walk. But then we are reaching to such a risky spot. No doubt government has constructed this all, therefore we can go very easily, but otherwise it is very risky to reach to such a spot. Nageshwar caves are there in front of us. View of dam now is very clear. View of hotel. We have ordered our food. Until it get ready, we are having time that we can go and see this all. This is the end portion of the point. Once again, thanks to government. It was light facility. Electricity is not there here, but the solar lamps they have there. So if you are staying here at night, we are having light part. Now this is the steep part Sahyadri Mountain. We have to climb this. My recommendation is there that you should go there for Nageshwar also. No doubt road is not available. We have to carry a trek either from Fort Vasota, you can go, or from Futhin, there is village called as Choravne, and Sapirli, from that we can climb to Nageshwar. But very high climbing is there, around 1000 meter we have to climb, and road is not there. This is Mahimandangad. For Mahimandangad road is there till the foothill, then we have to climb. So after spending much of the time here, we have to start journey once again. The back journey for this point, but this is all picturesque. Some car is descending out from this road. A nice sunlight, very good D vitamin is available in this sunlight. Myself in the shadow, and now we are going back after enjoying this all. Enough place for parking. Some old house is there. And now this is, we are entering in the valley of Zawli. There is a pass, just crossing out this pass, we are entering in the valley of Zawli. You'll feel the dense forest. Road now henceforth, motorable road is there, but this road is not completely in good condition. Once upon time this was in good condition, but now it is all destroyed. Here we are experiencing very high rainfall, and the most important thing in these areas, villages are there, but they don't have that good population. Very less population is there in this forest. We are getting availability of water, a borewell and hand pump is also available. We cross this dense forest part and coming to open area here. This what we are observing, this part that is called as a parvat. Parvateshwar is the name of temple at top of this. This is all Sahyadri Mountain. We are observing other side of Sahyadri Mountain, because just before that, whatever the side we were observing, that side was towards coastal line. So that was having depth of nearly 1000 meter plus, whereas this is towards plateau region. So here we are not getting much height, hardly 300 to 600 meter altitude we can experience at this side. So road conditions are not that good, but we have to keep in mind that we have to drive like this road condition to observe this fantastic beauty. So this is Koyna backwater. We are carrying out this recording in month of March, where water is going down. Otherwise, if you are visiting this place in month of December, November, then obviously this dam is completely full. Some hut-like provision is there, and parking space is also available. Here, only the villagers are traveling. Otherwise, nobody is here. So, very nice tourist place. Remote areas and very, very beautifully. Particularly if you are having visiting out this in the month of November or December, it will be really a green area in that part. Now we are getting closer to a place called as Bamloli and Tapola. This hill that is visible from Kas Plateau. Here we are getting the layers in the soil, that how water is descending out, going down. So highest level of water, that is also marked here. Whereas now we are getting steps, how it is going down and down and down. This is Koyna backwater. Electricity is produced. Hydel electricity project that is there at Koyna Nagar in Satara district, in Pofri in Ratnagiri district. We are observing fantastic trees. Now for some trees it is shedding of leaves and we are having this type of red flower. Here we will get variety of trees, various medicinal plants, and what is the most important thing, very good number of animals. Here bisons, tigers, leopards, variety of snakes, bear, all these animals are here. Certain villages, temples, and really a beautiful area, waterful as well as beautiful area that is available. This is all Zawri Valley, Koyna backwater. This area is having very good historical importance. This valley was ruled by a dynasty called as Mori. They claim that they are a descendant of the great emperor of India, ancient India, that is Chandragupta Maurya. Now road conditions are good at some places. We can really enjoy driving. See the road, it appears like directly we are going in the water only. So to the right side we have water, Koyna backwater. Left side we have hill, and the entire journey is through the forest. Now we are approaching to the place called as Bamloli. From Bamloli, Satara is comparatively closer, around some 30-40 kilometer distance from Bamloli to Satara. Satara is main city here, whereas boating facility is available. Villagers are using boat to travel from one end to other. So here, if I want to go to Bamloli, just I have to cross this water. But if you want to go by road only compulsory, then the distance is too much. We have to travel nearly 60 to 70 kilometers to reach to other part. So here we will get that villagers are using these boats and traveling. Really an enjoyable journey through this blue water. We have also enjoyed because from Bamloli we can go to the place that is called as Vasota. Just before I have shown there Vasota and Nageshwar. So for that we can travel through this boat. Some 1.5 hour pleasant journey is there to Vasota. This is the place where boats are available. Even water sports are there. Scooter launches are available. The place that is called as Tapola. So Bamloli and Tapola, they are two ends. Now what I am showing here is Bamloli and the place nearby, that is Tapola. So this is all we can say, that very nice journey is available. These type of roads are there, so we can get your vehicle here and then we can travel, say, water sports again. But there is a facility available. These boats are going towards a place that is Tapola now. So we can take your vehicle to Tapola by these boats. So even a car is taking out here. Now this is the Fort Makrangad, the fort on the top of Sahyadri Mountain. This is the Makrangad Fort in the deep valley of Zawri. And now we decided to stay there on this fort. So we climbed there by our Maruti Omni. The vehicle can go till nearly 80% of the top, where the village is there called as Ghonaspur. Very nice advanced village is there, that is Ghonaspur. And from Ghonaspur, we can stay there at Ghonaspur. Or if you want to climb, then you can go to the top of the fort, where another temple is available. So you can stay in the temple of Lord Shiva at top, or you can stay at Ghonaspur temple. That temple is also outside the village. So here, this is the Makrangad fort, very nice fort, and electricity is available till top. You have to pay some donation to the development of this temple to the villagers, and you can stay in that temple. A nice pinnacle is there. What we traveled, that is Koyna Backwater, that can be observed from the top. Just we have photographed. Now from this fort we can observe Pratapgarh Fort. Right now we are focusing on this Pratapgarh Fort. It's early morning and so fort is in haze, but we are trying to zoom certain temples and houses on fort. They are visible. There is statue of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj on the top of this fort, but right now due to haze we are not able to locate. So some sort, those who are visited there, they can see the statue, but not that clearly visible. Whereas temple of Mata Bhavani is there on the top. Some bastions, fortification walls, they are also observable. Whereas this is also on the top of Sahyadri Mountain. This is all Zawri Valley. Mahabaleshwar is nearby. This Makrangad Fort, that is observable from a point that is called as Babington Point of Mahabaleshwar, as well as Sunset Point of Mahabaleshwar. Actually Fort Makrangad, see, this is all Arthursit Point of Mahabaleshwar. We are focusing here, this is Arthursit Point. Then Lodwick Point or Elephant Head Point, Sunset Point, all these points are visible here. This is the top of fort. Some monument is there, and temple of Lord Shiva. This is the temple of Lord Shiva. Makrangad is looking like Saddleback. This is the one top of saddle, whereas another top of saddle is focused here. This is another top of saddle, and in between that valley is there. This is where we are standing, is Makrangad, or this other part that is called as Madhugad, but there is no good surface area there and no proper road is available to go there. This is all deep forest of Zawri. This is the sharp edges of Sahyadri. Here I am focusing out at another edge of Sahyadri intentionally. Very good tourist spot can be developed. See the sharp edge. Here some other forts are also there from Pratapgarh. Other than Pratapgarh, there are Rasalgarh, Sumargarh, and Mahipatgarh. Now we are descending out from Mukrandgarh. This type of road that is available for Mukrandgarh. Now this Ghonaspur village is not a big village. Hardly 40 houses are there, and government is constructing out road, motorable road till that village. Professor Dinesh Kolge, the experienced off-road driver, is now driving on this road. Very much thankful to government that they have constructed road till here. So why I am saying this? Because in 95-96 era, we have visited this fort, and at that time no motorable road was there, and we had to climb this entirely. The height of this Mukrandgarh is more than 1200 meters. Many people are confusing between meters and feet. So this is somewhere 1200 plus meters height is there, and we have climbed this all from base village, that is called as Dudgaon and Chaturbet. From that height is not 1200 meter, but nearly 500 to 700 meters we had to climb. But now at least this type of road is available. At certain places they have carried out development of road. Tar road is available in certain area, but still the road is not an easy road to drive. Very we have to get careful, and then we have to drive. At certain places we are getting very good road, but the condition, the road is already, say, may it is tar road, may it is not complete tar, but still we are having this type of sharp turns, and many times deep valleys are there towards one end. Because of these trees, we are not able to observe sometimes these deep valleys, but we are having complete deep valleys at one side, and we are driving out. So this is the pleasant road. A very good tar road is available here at some places, and we'll get the importance of this tar road when we are driving for a long on raw road. Then we'll get really the importance. Now this is dense forest area. This forest is called as Jawli village, a Jawli forest or valley of Koina. This was ruled by More, the dynasty. They claim that they are descendant of Chandragupta Maurya, an ancient emperor of India. But this valley was so densely covered by forest, and today also it is, that in ancient period nobody was able to defeat these Mauryan kings or More kings. The king here was having title as Chandra Rao, and they defeated even massive army of Mahmud Dawan, once upon prime minister as well as general of Bahmani dynasty. Mahmud Dawan was considered as invincible person in this area, but his troops were uprooted in the Jawli. So this is really a great area. So we can observe a road roller here, and I must say the driver of this road roller is really a great driver, because it's very difficult to take this roller through such a road to such high altitude. Because many times we came across a sharp turns and steep road, directly climbing up in nearly 20 degree or 15 degree, like that in slopes are there. Fantastic tree getting new leaves, and we are enjoying this road again and again. Here various animals are there, birds are there. In early morning we have another recording where in the early morning, we can notice sounds of variety of birds. This journey we started at Kher. At early morning, around 7 o'clock we started, and we ended our journey at Ghonaspur around 7 p.m. So 12-hour journey, because we were not only making traveling, we are observing, sightseeing and all that. Then we have to climb this all road, and ultimately around 7 o'clock we were there at Ghonaspur. So nearly 12 hours journey through this vehicle. Then we climbed this entire fort, and then after that we started our journey around 8:45 morning and started descending out. So we are now returning to Mumbai. The roads, intentionally we are showing here that what is the road condition. May be possible, I'm again telling, this is recording carried out in March 2021. So if you are coming here in after 2 years or 3 years, then may be possible that we will get tar road completed. Now this road will enter on a small plateau where we'll get only grassland. Then again we have to descend down. This is evergreen forest of Sahyadri. Now how to reach there? So here at Makrangad, not necessary you have to come from Kher, you can come from Mahad, Polatpur. From Polatpur we have to turn towards Mahabaleshwar. Once you are reaching to the foothills of Pratapgad, there is a village called as Wada or Kumbharoshi. After this village, you have to keep close eye on your right side. Here you have to cross Koyna River. There is an arc. Road is available, so start turning towards right. Somewhere after village Kumbharoshi, after 2 kilometers, around 2 kilometers from Kumbharoshi towards Mahabaleshwar, there is a right turn. Then again you have to drive 2 kilometers in deep forest. Then there is a T junction, we have to take left, where you will get a very nice bridge. That bridge is on Koyna River, constructed. It is said that this bridge is constructed during rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. So very very old bridge is there, and yet it is in very good condition. After that you can travel towards Dudhgaon or Chaturbet. Then we have to take right and cross Koyna River once again. From that you will not get very good road. Road condition is getting declining, and then after crossing Chaturbet village, you have to check whether arc is there towards Ghonaspur, and through this arc we can start our journey towards Makrangad. So if you want to travel here by road, then my advice is travel by bike or by four wheeler. If you are coming here by bike, you'll get both practices, that very good road condition but hilly areas, as well as off-road driving also. If you want to come here by public transport, then you have to come to Wada or Kumbharoshi. That you can travel from Mumbai via Mahad Polatpur Mahabaleshwar road, but you should not go to Mahabaleshwar. Prior to that only, some 17-18 kilometer prior to Mahabaleshwar, we can go, we can get down, and we have to wait for a bus that will lead you towards Chaturbet or Dudhgaon. From Dudhgaon you can start walking, and this all road you have to walk. some 7-8 kilometer journey is there, so you can walk this, or through forest also shortcut road is available, but I will not recommend you that road, because we traveled that by that road twice. So first time we were having a native person of that Ghonaspur, and so we went very easily, but next time when we traveled, we lost in the forest for some time, because in forest there is nobody that we can ask road, and if two or three roads are there, then problems are there. So it is advisable to go by this road. So we are entering in the deep forest area slowly, because at foothills of this all, always a very good forest is available. If you are coming here in rainy season, it will be really beautiful, but not easy to drive. This is that dense forest area exactly at foothill. You see the height of trees, that is also very, very high. Now almost all end of this pleasant forest journey. No doubt ahead of this also forest is there. This is a very raw forest. Here no much of the human population is there, and preserved from ancient period this forest. Now we are getting closer and closer to the tar road that is coming from Kher via Raghuvir Ghat to Chaturbet and Dudhgaon. From Dudhgaon onwards, this road is connected to Dudhgaon Umbharoshi road. Now we are there on tar road. It's very, very pleasant. After a long time, we are getting once again to the tar road. And the most important thing in this wood, the touch wood, our vehicle was not giving any problem. This is the bridge constructed by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. A board is there, and henceforth we have to take right. Now this is the main road, that is Polatpur to Mahabaleshwar road, where this is Pratapgarh, and we have to take left if you want to go to Pratapgarh. This is the left, where very good tar road is available to Pratapgarh. This is end of Satara district, and we are entering into Raigarh district. To the left side there is Pratapgarh. To the right side we can observe Sahyadri ranges, Mahabaleshwar area. Thanks for observing this prolonged video and my prolonged commentary. Observe kindly our other videos also, because this is entire video, but in other videos we have shown this part by part. So on same channel you can observe our videos, our other videos. Thanks for observing this.